Hey, everybody. Happy Friday, late afternoon, late summer here. Missy Jenn. Hi, Missy Jenn. How are you? Missy Jenn, my number one wing girl here. And we're going tonight. It is, once again, time for Friday Night Foodies, Friday Night Restaurant Reviews. And we often get asked, one of my new friends, mom of three boys, is just a wonderful gal. And she's on a very restricted diet. She's interested in vegan and vegetarian food. And I want to make a cake for her in a few weeks there. But it made me kind of think, Missy Jenn, we did go to this one place out in the little town of Sebastopol that we really enjoyed before. It was called Slice of Life, and it has the distinction of probably being the longest lasting, would you say, hippie come vegetarian restaurant in the whole county. It's been around since the 1970s. I mean, in restaurant life, that's like almost unheard of. Missy Jenn, to not have changed directions and stuff. So we're going to be heading out to Slice of Life in Sebastopol. We gave it a very high rating last time. We also ran into a remember that beautiful blonde gal that came over to our table? Well, I know you. Yeah, you're Rosie. And she started shaking her boobies and stuff right in the restaurant. Everybody's looking like, really?
She leaned over and was shaking her.
And I kind of threw her under the bus. She's like, well, she does that every day. Rosie, get up and do that. I'm like, do I know you? Just joking, honey. Of course I do. So one of my, what would you call them, Missy Jenn? The silent majority. The ones that sit out there and enjoy the content. And yet not everybody has to comment, for sure. And if you're trans, a lot of people feel like, I don't want to make a comment on that.
Yeah.
People will think I'm supporting and stuff. But, it's all good. It's all good just to have you guys here. Is a blast, and that's all I care about. If you're here, you're a pal, and that is a wonderful thing. So we are headed out Highway 12 West, if you're playing the home game, on California Highway 12, heading towards Sebastopol. Glad to have you along. Thank you. they don't look really healthy, you know. They don't seem real robust. I know they probably have a lot more longevity than I have, but sometimes they kind of look like they may be a little ragged out and stuff, so I don't know. Anyway, we are out here in the town of Sebastopol. This is the place where hippiedom never died from the 1960s and 1970s. This is Jerry Garcia country, Grateful Dead, Mickey Hart on keyboard, all right here out in Sebastopol. Okay, let's head into Slice of Life. Can we sit over here, honey?
Anywhere you want to sit.
Okay, thank you. Sit right in here. Here we are at the Slice of Life. A huge menu, isn't it? Veggie burgers. I'm going to have a veggie burger tonight. That's what I'm going to have. How are you? Some water out. There's a kitchen area back there. That's what I need. I need a veggie burger. Raja Taco. Mexicali. Veggie wrap. That's what I had last time. Veggie wrap, baked ziti, veggie wrap. I think that's what I'm gonna have. Choice of patty, black bean, vegetable, or nut burger. Always the most friendly staff back there that cooks here. Remember last time? I think I'm going to try one of these Butte Creek Pilsner. That might be kind of nice. See what that tastes like. Are you mad, bro? Are you ready to go vegetarian tonight? I'm going to have the avocado ranch burger. Now I'm going to give Missy Jenn a chance to look at the menu. Okay. Thank you. What did you end up getting?
A full stack.
You're getting pancakes for dinner.
Pancakes with bananas and nuts.
Okay.
And real
rice. All right, there we go. I think you can tell a real vegetarian kitchen, but look at all the spices up on the top rack up there. Just oodles and oodles of spices. Kind of cool. I'm going to try a Guayaki herbal tea here because I couldn't get the beer I wanted. I know I'm so healthy, it's crazy, for dinner tonight. With a little bit of honey in it. So Guayaki herbal, which comes right down from right down the street at the plant for your Guayaki yerba mate. Did I say that right? Why? Yucky! You hungry? I'm pretty hungry. Me too. This guy's making my herbal tea over there as we speak. I don't usually drink tea, but I want to see what this is like. This herbal tea.
It's nice to try something different.
I have enough beer tonight with baking and everything. So.
You'll have plenty of beer.
Yeah. So here it is. Guys dropping shit all over the place. Here we go. Alright, well, here we go.
It'll be nice to have a cup of tea. A proper cup of tea.
Thank you, bro. Thank you. And here's the honey. Glory be. I wish I could put the whole bottle in. This'll be good as it is. Thank you. Here it is, the avocado burger with the blue corn tortillas. This is like a mustard, what do you call it, like a mustard chutney. It's quite tasty. Got the looks like a bacon there. Onion, avocado, and it's a nut patty. It's made with nut. Well, let's check out Missy Jenn. She's gonna take her first bite. Drill down on that. Looks pretty good. I like the way the bananas are incorporated right into it.
Yes. And the nuts.
All right, here we go. That's like a whole wheat pancake too.
It's very delicious.
Looks good. Fire that in. You got those bananas have been caramelized a little bit. They look good.
Really nice flavor composition with them being incorporated.
Great. I love these blue corn tortilla chips. They're delicious. Nice substantial bun. Whole wheat bun. Thank you. explosion of nut flavor in my mouth was amazing here. The texture of the bun and the nut burger is amazing with the salad, and it has like a ranch style dressing on top. Really quite delicious. Really good. This is the real surprise though, this stuff.
Okay, what kind of any waters for outside, Dylan?
Delicious. This is like the first hamburger I've had in years. It holds together. It doesn't fall apart. Look at this. All right, let's eat. Tale of the tape. Your server was Jenica. Slice of life in Sebastopol, California. The avocado burger, 10/25, no extras, made with the nut patty. Jen had the pancakes, adding in $3 for bananas, $3 for nuts. So she was the expensive girl tonight at $16 for that. Hope you enjoyed it. Woo! And we had the guayaki tea. It wasn't the mint. It was, I didn't taste any mint, but it was pretty good. Pretty good. So all in, we're $27.75 plus tax. And I'm very, very happy. How about you?
I'm very happy too.
You did it again. We'll see you guys outside. Slice of life. Did it for us again, didn't they?
They've done it again.
They did it again, guys. They
what
just
a surprise.
Did. I guess I shouldn't be surprised, because if you think about a restaurant that's lasted since 1974, you guys can do the math how many years that is. That's a lot of years. They must be doing something right to keep bringing people back there, because I'll tell you, I'm not going to kid you, that's one of the most delicious burgers I've ever had in my life, that nut burger with the avocado and that sauce. And the blue corn tortilla chips along with that mustard sauce was just amazing. The only downside was the service was kind of lackadaisical, but there's only one gal covering the whole place in there. And that, you know, the kid that's helping out, he looked kind of stoned and stuff, but it's okay. It's Sebastopol, right? You're supposed to be stoned. You're smiling at her, right?
Yeah.
Missy Jen's looking around thinking, shit, everybody's stoned. Everybody's stoned.
And I'm trying to blend in some actors.
She can't even breathe the air too much around here without feeling stoned. Anyway, I'm going to give this a 9.5 rating tonight, and this is as good as it was the last time here for me. If the service had been a little more attentive and the menu had been a little more fleshed out with the beer, didn't have the beer I wanted, I just figured, well, I'll just have the tea tonight, which was delicious too. Guayaki Herba Mate hot tea was delicious with the honey. So for me, it's a 9.5 star experience. It's as good as the first time we reviewed it about a year and a half ago, and we wanted to re-review that again. So Jen, what do you think?
I remember last time we
nice
were
and loud
here.
For everybody.
Last time we were here, I had that nut burger. This time I had the pancakes. Totally different venue I went this time. And I thought if I go with the pancakes, I might trick them and get some that, you know, they might not be so good, but by golly, those pancakes were just the best freaking pancakes that I've ever eaten out.
Remember, they were $16 there. They weren't cheap. You take them and you spike them up with the nuts and...
They were with the gluten-free...
It cost some money for the gluten-free...
Wheat... pancakes. And then they added the... those were real natural bananas.
We'll star it up.
And then the that's another thing. I'm kind of shocked that they added $3 for each, but quality has its price. And for them to just then fry it all together and melt it in, it was a flavor composition.
That wasn't bad. Of the, like 27 of the bucks finest, wasn't bad.
And I just drank water and I was fine with that.
Yep.
So I'm really, really, really pleased. And I've got to say the staffing, I wish they had like another waiter or waitress there that could help out. So I'm going to give them a 9-star, okay. nine star rating,
right.
Because this year we are a little bit tougher.
All right, there we go, guys. Slice of life. Would you return again? I'd return in a heartbeat. Here.
Yes, I would.
Absolutely.
Anytime.
This place, if you're if you have vegophobia, fear of vegetarian restaurants and vegetarian food. Now, we've had some lousy ones, but I'll tell you, this doesn't qualify. This is an outstanding one. And I'll say once again, restaurant that's lasted since 1974 is doing something right. It's evidence on the face of it that they're doing something right. And these guys hit it out of the park.
Absolutely.
If I come out of here a meat eater and I tell you that's one of the best burgers I've ever had in my life, well, learn to love it, brother, because that's the way it is. 9.5 stars from me and 9 stars from Missy Jen. There it is, a slice of life in Hippie Town, Sebastopol, California. Thanks for being along.